This is a tiny A-frame Kubo and Subic, and you can book it for as low as 1,700 pesos per night. Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Tiny Stays and Tiny Getaways. My name is Leia, and just like many of us living in Metro Manila, my husband Jamie and I are looking for, you know, out-of-town trips that will not break the bank. Well, this place is definitely a steal. We're at Mango Nest, and it's a perfect getaway for two. It has this nice laid-back beach vibe to it, which is perfect because we're in the middle of a rainforest, and we're in Subic, which is known for its beaches. It may be tiny, but it has a lot of character. Once you enter, you'll immediately see the bed, which is nice and comfortable. The sheets are clean and obviously freshly washed. I just slept well during our stay. On one of the side tables, you'll find drinking water, glasses, and the host thoughtfully provided a bottle of natural disinfectant and citronella insect repellent. On the other side, you'll find a nightlight, a kettle, an electric mosquito lamp, and they even left a jar of treats. There's a beach bag, which is actually a bayong, with things that you'll need should you decide to hit one of the beaches in Subic. Now, if you're worried that it's gonna be hot or humid, there's a ceiling fan, and if it's not enough, the place is air-conditioned. Just remember to turn it off when you're not using it. I personally just like to leave the door open and tie the curtains to the sides during the day, so the A-frame has a nice open feel to it. I just love how it integrates the outdoors to the room itself, so it feels much bigger than it really is. And even when you're inside, it feels like you're outside because of the view of the trees and the plants. It's such a welcome break from the city where everything's just made out of concrete. So yeah, it's nice to see a lot of greens for a change. But of course, when the sun is shining too brightly, you can always choose to close the curtains. The host provided a guidebook with the do's and don'ts of the property, along with tips on where to go, where to eat, things like that, everything that you'll need. You know, it's really these nice, thoughtful touches that get me, and based on the drawings and the notes of the other guests before us, I can tell that they feel the same way. Now, in the guidebook, we were told to be wary of two things: monkeys and insects. We didn't really have a lot of problems because all you really have to do is clean up after yourself and don't leave food unattended. Pro tip: use the insect repellent provided by the host or bring your own, you'll need it. My husband Jamie and I just really wanted to chill and relax, so we spent most of the time in Mango Nest. Hindi na kami masyado lumabas sa Subic, and we really just enjoyed, you know, sitting on the lounge chairs, or maybe we rolled out the banig and put some pillows and just stayed there at the garden. It was nice and quiet and peaceful, exactly what we needed. Guys, there's no kitchen in the property, but the host did provide a grill and utensils and plates. So yeah, if you want to be a grill master, go ahead, give it a shot. Or if you want to be tamad like us, you can just order. Ako, I just really wanted to disconnect while I was there, but if you want to stream movies on Netflix, or if you really need to get work done, the place does have decent Wi-Fi. Siyempre, we're in a tropical country and we want our drinks to be cold. Now, the place does have a mini fridge, but it's a couple of steps away. Pero may cooler naman na provided, so I suggest that you use that. Keep, you know, water, your favorite soda there, whatever, so you don't have to walk all the way to the mini fridge whenever you want a cool, refreshing drink. Now, let's talk about the bathroom situation. The one on the Mango Nest is small, but it's clean and it's complete. So you have shampoo, conditioner, hand wash, tissue, all those things. But much like the mini fridge, it's also a couple of steps away. So here's a short video clip so you have an idea more or less how much you have to walk. So this is us going from the bathroom back to the A-frame. Once the sun sets, the tiny house is still Instagrammable. The lighting is nice and cozy, the trees are lit, which helps a lot with the vibe. It's just so chill and calm and peaceful. You'll find yourself sleeping extra early when you're checked in. Kami ni Jamie, we left the city to relax, and that's exactly what we got. And that's it for our tour of this tiny A-frame Kubo in Subic. If you're thinking of booking the place for your next getaway, for your next escape, then I leave the Airbnb link in the description box below, so do check it out. And if you have any questions, do leave a comment and I'll try to answer it as accurately as possible. While you're at it, give this video a like and subscribe to the channel. And for our next tiny getaway, we're going paragliding in Rizal. Abangan! Bye!